Through the night, survivors have been using their bare hands to peek over the twisted ruins of multi-story apartment blocks, trying to save family, friends, and anyone who was inside when the first massive 7.8 magnitude quake struck early on Monday. The sense of disbelief is widespread as residents struggle to comprehend the scale of the disaster. Some of the heaviest devastations occurred near the quake's epicenter between Karamamaras and Gaziantep, a city of 2 million people. Where entire blocks now lie in ruins under gathering snow. With aftershocks rattling the area, many terrified and exhausted survivors spent the night outdoors, too afraid to go home. Turkey has put the latest death toll at 3,419 in that country alone, bringing the confirmed tally in both Turkey and Syria to 5,021. There are fears that the death toll will rise, with the World Health Organization officials estimating up to 20,000 people may have died. Overwhelmed medics are struggling to treat the estimated 20,000 people who've been injured. The initial earthquake was so powerful it was felt as far away as Greenland and was followed by a series of aftershocks, including a 7.5 magnitude tremor that struck in the middle of search and rescue work on Monday. The impact is devastating and has sparked a global response, with dozens of nations from Ukraine to New Zealand vowing to send help. But in winter, major roads into the area are covered in ice and snow, and officials say three major airports have been rendered inoperable, complicating deliveries of vital aid. Much of the quake-hit area of northern Syria has already been decimated by years of war and aerial bombardment by Syrian and Russian forces that destroyed homes, hospitals, and clinics. The Syrian Health Ministry reported damage across the provinces of Aleppo, Latakia, Hama, and Tartus, where Russia is leasing a naval facility. Even before the tragedy, buildings in Aleppo, Syria's pre-war commercial hub, often collapsed due to the dilapidated infrastructure. Officials have cut off natural gas and power supplies across the region as a precaution and have closed schools for 2 weeks. The UN cultural agency UNESCO expresses fears over heavy damage in two cities on its heritage list, Aleppo in Syria and Diyarbakir in Turkey. The United States, the European Union and Russia have all sent condolences and offers of help. Turkey is in one of the world's most active earthquake zones. The country's last 7.8 magnitude tremor was in 1939, when 33,000 people died in the eastern Erzincan province. The Turkish region of Durrse suffered a 7.4 magnitude earthquake in 1999, when more than 17,000 people died. Experts have long warned a large quake could devastate Istanbul, a megapolis of 16 million people filled with rickety homes.